Oh, happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
Ooh, yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Oh.
Merry Christmas. Happy holidays.
Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Welcome to another Christmas video. Really hope you guys are enjoying the Christmas content that I am putting up so far. I am absolutely loving filming all of these festive themed videos for you guys, and obviously I'm doing Vlogmas as well. So if you are new here, then make sure you subscribe. I'm doing two videos, so I am doing a Vlogmas video every day and a sit down Christmas video every second day throughout the month of December leading up to Christmas. So there's a lot happening on this channel. As you can tell by the title of this video, this is a Christmas wish list video. I have done one of these in the past, like a couple years ago now. I really enjoyed filming it, and I really enjoy watching all of these types of videos on YouTube from other people. It kind of like gives me ideas on things to ask for Christmas or things I can give other people for Christmas. I thought I'd film another one. So sorry if you can hear stuff in the background. Phil is loading the dishwasher behind the door, so that's what that is, in case you're wondering. Basically, I've compiled a list on my phone of a few things that I will be asking for Christmas this year. So if you'd like to know what is on my Christmas list, then just keep watching. So first things first, we have a book. I have been wanting this book for a really, really long time. That is Harry Potter and the Cursed Child. I have all of the other Harry Potter books apart from this new one, which was released probably like a couple years ago now, I think, which basically like tells the story of like Harry's children. Obviously I want to know what happens. I really, really love Harry Potter. I love all of the movies. I love the books. I'm currently reading the fourth book, which is The Goblet of Fire. Highly recommend the books if you're a big reader and you haven't yet read the Harry Potter series. J.K. Rowling is a really, really talented author. Also, the cover of the book looks like this. Next up, I have some prints from Desenio. So if you are not familiar with the website Desenio, basically they are, I think they're UK based. They have a lot of really, really nice artwork. They have a lot of different themes. I just think their prints are so, so cute. I think they're quite affordable from memory, but it will just be like the cost of actually shipping. They ship to Australia. Above my bookcase I have a very, very blank wall that I only have a clock on at the moment, and I really would like some artwork to hang up there. Now I am not overly fussed with the artwork in Kmart or the warehouse. Like this piece up here was from the warehouse, this piece was from the warehouse, but they don't really have anything that kind of matches my color scheme. So my color scheme in my living room is like a mustard, a white, a grey, a navy blue, and a black. I also would love like three small prints to put above my wardrobe. Eventually I do want to do a gallery wall when we move house, but the apartment that we're in at the moment is too small for that, unless I did it on like the bookcase wall, but then I feel like that would be like taking over and I kind of want that to be like a feature. I'm not sure which ones. I have a lot of favourite ones, but not ones that I could comfortably say I want that in my living room. So I kind of have to like sit through with the person and kind of go through, I guess. Next up, I have some makeup brushes. So I asked for this for Christmas last year and I got like a really cute set of like eye brushes. I would really like a set of face brushes, either from the brand Real Techniques, Morphe, or Exo Beauty. Exo Beauty is Shannon's brand, and I really like the look of her brushes, but I've never tried them before. And obviously I wear makeup, and makeup brushes make the world of a difference. So I really would like to get some nice, good quality new ones for Christmas. And probably also along the lines of that is some brush cleaner as well, because I have not cleaned my makeup brushes and they are well overdue. The next thing I've written on here, I know that if I ordered this now it would not arrive in time for Christmas, but I also wouldn't be too mad about it if someone got it for me for Christmas. And that is one of the Zoella neon signs. So if you don't follow Zoella here on YouTube, which you totally should, she recently released a couple of neon signs. There's two of them. One of them looks like this. One of them looks like this. I would really, really like the one with the boobs on it. The other one is very, very expensive. The other one is almost $400 pounds, which is like double that here in New Zealand. And just no one has that kind of money just to like spend that much on something so minuscule, other than people who are like completely, completely loaded, who run like very successful businesses. The other one is like $39.99 in pounds, so that's about $80 New Zealand. So that's more affordable than the other one. I know that the money all does go to charity, which is amazing. So obviously helping out a charity is really, really good as well. I'd love to put it on my dressing table, and you can get like different stickers for the nipples and stuff, which I think is kind of cute. And obviously it's like a light up neon pink sign, which I love neon pink stuff. This flamingo here is a light up pink neon flamingo. I actually got that given to me in one of my previous, what I got for Christmas from Secret Santa from one of my workmates. I know she bought it at Kmart though, but I use that all the time, especially when Phil and I are going to bed, and I really, really like it. And just obviously as we kind of slowly move from like smaller apartments to a house, it would be nice to have like a few more of those kind of just scattered throughout the house. A decanter cocktail set from Kmart. So Kmart released this in with their Christmas stuff. It's like a gold cocktail shaker and like brush set. I'll insert a photo now. And I really, really wanted one of these from Farmers to put on the bar cart, but they're like $60 at Farmers, and I just can't justify spending that much money for something that I'm only gonna use like if I have a party or like on very like specific occasions. If you guys don't know, we have a bar cart and I've been slowly collecting things to put on that. We don't have a cocktail shaker and it's only like $14, so I'm like, that's such a good price. And it's gold, which matches the rest of the colours that I've got on the bar cart. Next thing I've written on here is the new Shaaanxo palette. So again, if you don't follow Shaaanxo, then you won't know, but she recently released her own eyeshadow palette. It's called Heaps of Sweets. It looks like this. I just think it looks so, so cute, and oh my gosh, I would love to receive that for Christmas. I currently have her two other palettes, which is Shaaanxo the Remix and the original Shaaanxo palette. This one she's actually done with her own company, which is really, really cool, and I'm so proud of her because this is like her lifelong dream, so I would love to get behind her and support a fellow New Zealander. I just think the colours are absolutely stunning and the packaging is so, so cute, and usually her stuff is really, really affordable as well, which is great for those of us in New Zealand because New Zealand makeup is not cheap. It's quite expensive. An oil diffuser and then like a couple of essential oils to put in them. I have always wanted one of these. I kind of want one for our bedside table or one to go in the living room because they've been like a big trend recently. I feel like it would be nice to like put lavender oils in it when Phil and I are trying to go to sleep, or like calming oils if we're really, really stressed, because I get stressed so, so easily. So I feel like it would just be kind of nice, or just like a nice summery one to kind of put through the oil diffuser in the summertime, because it's kind of too hot in the summertime to burn candles. You kind of still want your house to smell nice. I know you can get them from like Briscoe's or Farmers or Kmart, like you can get them from a variety of different places. So next up we have a picnic basket. Oh my goodness, I have been wanting a picnic basket for the longest time. Every time I go to a thrift store or an op shop here in New Zealand, I really look hard for these, but there are hardly any that aren't like $60 secondhand, and I'm like, I don't know if I can justify spending $60 on something that's secondhand. There was one that I saw at a market for $20, and ever since I saw that, I have kicked myself for not getting it. It is like a really cute small one that I have seen in Bed Bath & Beyond, and I think it's like $20. I just think it's like the perfect summer essential, like especially like if you're going to the beach or you're going to like a nice little park, or even if you're just like going out with friends to enjoy the sunshine, like you kind of need a picnic basket. The next thing is going to come as no surprise, and it is actually something I received last year for Christmas that came in so handy, and that is a voucher for Kmart. If you guys do not know, I love Kmart. I'd probably go as far as to say it's probably one of my most favorite shops. I've been in there so often recently, and they have so many cute things for such an affordable price that if you get someone a voucher for there, they can literally spend the entire voucher and get so many different items for their money. On Boxing Day, they release a lot of their Christmas stuff for really, really, really cheap. I mean, I would love to receive another one of those this year. And vouchers are great, like, if you don't know what to get somebody, but you want to get them something for Christmas or their birthday. Nice new summer sheet set. So Phil and I only have like 3 summer sheets, and that like includes the like bottom sheet that you put over the mattress. Like, we've got one of those and 2 more sheets, which is not enough for the summertime. So I would really like a new nice set. Our bed is a queen size, in case anyone is wondering. You can get some really nice ones from the Warehouse or Farmers, although generally they're quite expensive there. Or you can get some at Kmart for a more affordable price. Ideally, I would like some either white ones or pale pink ones. But I mean, they're sheets at the end of the day and no one's going to see them anyways. Or even grey ones, I think. Next thing is another thing from Kmart, and that is their gratitude journal. If you are not familiar with Kmart's journals, they have a few different ones. They have one for travel. They have a baby book one, which I really, really want to get. They have a wedding planning one, which I also really, really want to get. And they have a gratitude journal. Basically, in the gratitude journal, it says like things I will let go of, things I will work on, and something that went well, I think. It's something along those lines. They range from about $5 to $12, I think. And I just feel like it would be a very positive and uplifting thing to just write down things that you're grateful for every single day, and like things that you can kind of let go that aren't that big of a deal. And then the wedding one is really cool because it has like a section for ideas, and then you've got like kind of like a phone book part where like you have numbers for like your photographer, your makeup artist, your catering, like all those kind of things. And it has like about the venue, about the guests, about what you're wanting to wear and all that kind of stuff. And I just think it's so, so handy. And then the baby one obviously has like your first month, your first words, your first day that you walked, and like all those kind of things, like the essential things that you want to record. The next thing I've written on here is a clothing item, and that is from the Lauren Curtis loungewear brand. Again, if you don't watch Lauren Curtis on YouTube, you won't be familiar with her clothing brand. But she, over this past year, she's recently released a clothing brand that her and her boyfriend run together. They basically just make a whole lot of like PJs and like winter ones and summer ones and all those kind of things. And they came out with a Christmas range, and oh my gosh, they're so, so cute. And I really, really would like especially the like gingerbread PJ set. I think it's so, so, so cute. Like a summer set, so it'd be perfect for New Zealand, because obviously we are heading into summer now and it gets bloody hot in the summer, so you don't want to be wearing long PJ pants. And I would imagine they're not too pricey either. And then the lucky last thing that I have written on my list is a new perfume. I'm not after anything too expensive, because the one perfume I do really want is Black Opium by YSL, and that is like $300, so I'm like, no, maybe not for Christmas. But just like a nice little like fragrance mist, or like a nice little like new Britney Spears perfume, because if you guys don't know, I love the Britney Spears perfumes. They're so sweet. You can't really go wrong with the Britney Spears perfume, and they're also really affordable. Like, I think the like 50 mils are like around $60 or so, which is cheap for a perfume here in New Zealand. Like, if someone would like to buy me a more expensive one, that would be nice as well. I like a lot of like sweet fruity scents. I'm not a big fan on like strong mature scents. So yeah, that is everything I have written down on my list this year for things I would like for Christmas. I know obviously I'm not going to receive everything, but it would just be nice to receive like one or two of these items. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have missed any of my previous Christmas uploads, I will leave the playlist down below of all the videos I have done this year so far, and I will also leave my Vlogmas playlist down below, so if you are joining us for the first time, then you can kind of go back and watch the other ones that I've already put up, so that you're kind of up to date with the rest of the fam on what's going on. I've really, really enjoyed this video. Please subscribe if you haven't. Please turn on the notifications. It's just the little bell next to the subscribe button. It just helps you get notified every time I upload, because YouTube doesn't always tell you now when people that you're subscribed to upload, unless you have the notification bell turned on. Please check out my social media. It's all linked down below in the description. Give me a follow on those, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Oh look, you texted me.
What?
I didn't even see your text. Itchy eye. This, where is it? Ugh.